Hey, Viola, is it true that patients with some allergies can be at an increased risk for implant failure?
Find out today on Medical History Mysteries.
So it seems like peri-implantitis and implant failure is becoming more and more prevalent. And it sounds like there's more and more systemic conditions that are predisposing patients to such failures. Now allergies playing a role? Tell us about it.
Well, yeah, Pam, not just, how about medications causing implant failure? How about later studies that have said, you know, proton pump inhibitors like Nexium and H2 receptor antagonists like Pepcid, by reducing stomach acid production can therefore reduce calcium absorption and therefore cause implant failure. Even SSRIs have been implicated in dental implant failure. So it goes on and on. Now we find out that allergies have a role. Well, as it turns out, one study done by NYU College of Dentistry, happy to be a faculty member there at the dental hygiene program there, says that yes, patients who have penicillin allergy or more likely to have dental implant failure. And this was done on a study of 838 patients. And they found that dental implants failed in about 17% of the patients who had a penicillin allergy, compared to about 8% or 8.4% of patients without the allergy. Now, keep in mind, that means they took antibiotics other than amoxicillin, or other than penicillin. So for patients who took certain antibiotics other than amoxicillin, they were much less likely to have successful implants or more likely to have implant failure. For example, clindamycin ended up being about 20% implant failure and azithromycin a whopping 30% implant failure.
So it's not so much the person with the allergy, it's the medication that they can safely take after implant placement.
It seems like penicillin and amoxicillin will increase the success rate of the implant osseointegrating. Yes, but we don't know the science behind that. Now, the reason why this is important is because not only did they suffer the implant failure, they suffered an earlier implant failure. So this is early dental implant failure, less than 6 months. Whereas those people without the allergy, if they did suffer an implant failure, it might happen much later, around 12 months or so. But again, we don't know the reason why that they experience it. You know, it could be several factors. Maybe it's the material in the implant, or maybe it's just the fact that the antibiotic that we use other than amoxicillin just wasn't effective enough.
So for those implants that failed, did they all have the same antibiotic post-implant placement?
Well, they didn't. That was the thing. All we know for sure is that not using amoxicillin, not using penicillin, was the reason for the greater risk of implant failure. Now, keep in mind, you might say, well, why didn't we just use amoxicillin? The reason is that research shows that penicillin allergies are usually overstated. 90% of people who say they have penicillin allergies are not truly allergic to penicillin, according to many studies. So a lot of people believe it, but it's not true. Now, that meant we could have used amoxicillin because they really weren't allergic, but we thought they were because they thought they were. So if we actually did testing and got a true penicillin allergy level, then we can tell who would use penicillin and amoxicillin, therefore who would be likely to have more successful implants.
Wow, and that's interesting because I can't tell you how many patients put that they have an allergy to penicillin on our medical history. And when I ask them what reaction they had, it's usually GI.
Oh, yeah. I can tell you right now that a lot of people believe they are truly allergic because they had an adverse effect or because their mom was. I hear that a lot, but it's somehow inherited. Not to my knowledge. I don't believe so.
Wow. So another reason to check out our patient's medical history and dig deeper and identify if they do, in fact, have an allergy. It's kind of easy. And I mean, I've done it too, where we say, okay, no problem, no penicillin for you. But in some cases, with some certain procedures, that antibiotic might be indicated. And it's important for us to truly know if it's going to potentially benefit them versus the alternative.
One more time, Pam, as you and I like to say, it's all about the medical history.
All about the medical history. Wow. Well, that was really interesting. And I would imagine that more data is going to come out on this topic.
I would imagine so. Almost every study I read says, you know, more research is necessary. So I'm sure we'll see a further update in the future.
All right. Well, stay tuned. And when more research comes out, we'll definitely be happy to share it on Medical History Mysteries.
We'll be on it.
We'll be on it. All right, everybody. We will see you next week.